And certainly leading the charge in criminal justice reform with a new program which aims to offer alternatives to incarceration. So joining us this morning to fill us in on Justice 2020 and the plan is Borough President Eric Adams. So good morning to you and thanks for coming in this morning.
Thank you.
Before we get to the criminal justice talk, we're highlighting measles, new numbers out this morning showing an increase in Brooklyn and Queens. So you're the Brooklyn Borough President. What is your office doing about that to kind of get the word out about this?
It's about information, and oftentimes people believe when they don't go through the inoculation process with their child that it's just going to impact the family. That is not true. Measles is contagious. It's a simple two-step inoculation period. Mm-hmm. We're just really encouraging parents to understand that this is a real issue. This is not some simple rash. You can have some serious complications if you get mumps or the measles, and we're just really getting the information out there.
Is it tough in specific communities, Orthodox Jewish communities, where it's a religious thing?
Well, there's a waiver in New York State that mm-hmm. if you have health or religious reasons, you can get a waiver. And so we're encouraging people to not abuse that in any way. And we're really speaking with all of our ethnic groups and those in the Williamsburg and Borough Park mm-hmm. communities. They have been extremely aggressive, the leaders there, and responsible of trying to really stem this outbreak.
All right, now let's switch gears here and talk about Justice 2020, announced by District Attorney Eric Gonzalez earlier this week. So for those who don't know, what is the plan here and what's it going to accomplish?
Well, it's a combination of things, and I think the DA, he rolled it out to all of the electors in Brooklyn. This was part of the promises that were made on the campaign trail. Mm-hmm. Promises made, promises kept. And it's really refocusing our attention from only dealing with incarceration. How do you look at low level, particularly marijuana arrests, right, where his office has no longer prosecuted those arrests? And how do you find ways of those are nonviolent felons not using incarceration, but find an alternative program? It's a great concept.
So it's not just avoiding jail time.
Right. No, it's not. He's still a prosecutor, a full prosecutor. Those who are committing predatory crimes mm-hmm. or violent crimes, his office is fully equipped to prosecute them. But we need to really look at how we have abused the criminal justice system in the past, particularly for people, individuals who are dealing with economic issues.
Right, absolutely. Other big thing this week, Meatless Monday is now in the city schools. 3 years ago, I just learned you did a whole about face with your diet going fully vegan. So what is your thoughts on this whole Meatless Mondays now? I mean, I'm sure you're a fan of it.
Yes, I am. I spoke with the mayor about 2 years ago, and we just continue to push to get it done. And it's a twofold win. Number one, the WHO has classified processed meat mm-hmm. as a type 1 carcinogen. That's equivalent to cigarettes. We don't give our children Marlboro cigarettes in the morning. Why are we feeding over 900,000 meals to our children every day in the Department of Education?
But does it have to be that? Does it have to be that kind of meat? They can't go more natural?
Well, when you look at meat, our overconsumption of meat in this country, it does two things. Number one, it is the leading cause of environmental issues. Many people don't know that, and they don't associate it. Second, it is one of the leading causes, and it contributes to colon cancer. It contributes to so many other health disorders. For diabetics, the highest level of saturated fat is in meat. If you're eating meat and you're diabetic, mm-hmm. you are actually feeding your crisis. So we said we should not be feeding our children food that is going to be harmful to them.
Got it.
We talk about one day.
Right. One day. I think we could all get up for a day. Big party on Friday for Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, obviously notorious RBG. What's this party? Is she going to be there?
No, she's not. We wish she does this a surprise visit, but she's not.
And you want to name a building after her?
Yes, we do. We want to name the municipal building. Amazing person, multiple cancer survivor, Supreme Court justice, a real advocate for women issues. And the mayor stated last year, what his wife did, an analysis of statues and buildings mm-hmm. in the city. How do we start making sure we name them after various ethnicities?
Think it'll get done?
Women? Yes, I do.
Okay. And Cory Johnson's announced he's running. Are you running?
Yes, I am.
For mayor?
2021, we're putting together the team. We're trying to figure out the right route. And we, once the exploratory committee is done, we'll be ready to announce.
So you will be running for mayor?
Once we know for sure what the exploratory committee is doing right now, we'll be moving forward.